how many shutoffs does your utility do on a monthly basis for non-paying customers? Depending on your utility size, this could be a handful of customers, or it could be hundreds or even thousands per month. No matter how many it is, it's too many, and it's costing your utility valuable time and money. Today, we're going to discuss some of the great new technology options available to you for never rolling a truck again for non-payment customers. Let's dive into it. Welcome to the Smart Water Show, brought to you by Badger Meter. I'm your host, Maurice Blackwell, and this is the show where we discuss your day-to-day water utility problems and find the most effective technology solutions for you. Stay tuned for our question of the day at the end of this video to enter our weekly giveaway. In the late 90s, while I was working on my MBA, one of the classes that I enjoyed the most was my new product development class. I distinctly remember this one particular day where the professor asked a very thought-provoking question. He said this. He said, "In your industry, what is a major problem your customers deal with that there's currently no solution for?" He also added, he said, "Feel free to dream a little bit about the product solution." He says, "Even if the technology doesn't exist today." In those days, I was working as a marketing manager, and one of my favorite things to do when meeting with customers was to just to ask them the question, what are the biggest problems or hurdles that you're trying to overcome? For all of you that know me, you know I still ask that question today. As I began to ponder this question, the problem that came to mind from all these discussions that I've had with utilities all across the country was dealing with non-paying customers. Water utility operations are saddled with the drain on its available personnel resources, along with the safety concerns with putting their people in harm's way of angry customers. I began to sketch out a product that could restrict the flow of water from the office. Man, I wish I could find that sketch today. However, I'm here to tell you today that we don't have to dream anymore. Those products actually exist here in 2020. Many great engineering teams around the country at many great companies have figured this out, and that's what we're here to talk about today. There are a few product options available. There are add-on products where you can plumb into any water line. There are also products that have the flow restriction valve built right into the normal lay length of the meter, easily allowing you to adapt this to the current meter configuration without having to cut into the line. Let's talk about some of the other key features of these products. Some of them have multi-position capability where you can have an open, closed, and a partially closed setting. Some of them offer automatic maintenance cycles that will automatically exercise the valve once per month, even if you don't, to make sure the valve never gets seized up. When you think about it from the customer's perspective, many of these products also offer a way to improve the customer's experience by offering you a timely restoration to their water service. Most of these products will allow you to restore the customer service remotely within a 2-hour window. And for most utilities, that's probably an improvement over your current process. But at the end of the day, these products will actually save you money by eliminating the need to roll a truck to cut off and restore the customer service. For utilities that have put pen to paper to calculate the cost of a truck roll, the premium for these types of products will make perfect sense. Let's finish up today by diving into potential deployment strategies for this type of product. First off, do you need to deploy this everywhere? Well, probably not. Even though some utilities are going that way, what most utilities will do is target their repeat offenders. Most utilities will pick a time period, let's say 12 months. If you look at that customer base and you have customers that you're going to cut off more than twice over that 12-month period, that's a good place to start. For the majority of utilities, that's going to be somewhere between 5 and 8% of your customers. For most utilities, the ideal solution is the cellular-enabled valve, because no matter what type of meter reading system you're using today, from a manual read or touch read or even a mobile system, you can adapt these cellular-enabled valves wherever you need them in your system because the network is already there. If you have any questions about today's topic, feel free to ask a question in the comment section below. I'd be happy to provide you with an answer. Or if you'd rather send a private message or have a question related to metering or meter reading systems that I can help you with, be sure to connect with me on LinkedIn. Our question of the day: do you see a need for a product like this within your utility operation? A simple yes or no will do. Please provide your reply in the comment section below and be one of the first 20 people to reply to be entered into our weekly giveaway for one of our very stylish, highly sought after Smart Water Show stainless steel tumblers. If you found value in this content, be sure to click the like button. And if you have a colleague that would benefit from listening to this episode, be sure to click the share button as well. We'd like to thank you for watching this video, and we'll catch you next time on the Smart Water Show.